The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. Hope you pray and start your lessons every day, like how we do it in the class. A blessed day to you, children. Have you gone through the first lesson completely? Introduction to macroeconomics. I've sent all the materials through the Google Classroom and the WhatsApp group. I've given you homework. I've given you the learning material. I've also sent the PDF. Okay? Even if you don't have the textbook, you can follow it from the PDF. Have you completed the homework? Homework must be written in your economics rough notebook, and the question and answers sent through the materials must be written in your classwork along with the date. You can take any long size notebook, put the date, draw a margin, double margin, and then write the question with a black pen and answers with a blue. You can write the 2 marks questions and the 3 marks questions, like how we do it in the classwork. In the rough notebook, you are expected to write all the questions. The homework given to you must be written 2 marks, 3 marks, as well as 5 marks. Today, let us start with the national income. National income. So, we need to learn about the national income because every country faces a lot of issues like unemployment, inflation, and every country aspires to grow. There should be growth every day. So, to solve all these problems of unemployment, inflation and economic growth, we need to study the concept of national income. So in this chapter, I will be introducing the meaning of national income and some basic concepts of national income. You would have studied national income in the lower classes in your 9th standard. You would have studied the national income and some of the basic concepts of national income. Today, let us start with the meaning of national income. Meaning of national income. Can you see the slide? So there is a picture here, goods and services. What do you mean by goods? Things that people make or grow to sell, they are only termed as goods. Goods can be seen physically with our eyes. Goods are tangible. Goods can be seen, felt, and you can use a good. Whereas services are performed by people. When people perform jobs for others, the jobs are called as services. So here you have goods and services. Already in 11th standard, we have seen the types of goods and services. So let us come to the meaning of national income. The total money value of all final goods and services produced in a country during a particular period of time is called as national income. So in a layman's term, to an ordinary person, what is meant by national income? The total money value of all the goods. So I explain what is goods. Goods and these are the services produced in a country during a particular period of time is called as national income. So this is the meaning of national income. Next, we go on to the definition of national income. This is Alfred Marshall. So the definition given by Alfred Marshall is, the labor and capital of a country acting on its natural resources produce annually a certain net aggregate of commodities, material and immaterial, including services of all kinds. So when you read anything, you should pause wherever necessary to make the sentence meaningful. So I will read it again. You can mark it in your PDF, in the copies, in the textbook that you have. You can just draw a slash wherever I stop. To make it meaningful, I will read it again. The labor and capital of a country, acting on its natural resources, fossil, produce annually a certain net aggregate of commodities, material and immaterial, including services of all kinds. So this is called as the true net annual income or revenue of the country or national dividend. So national income can also be called as true net annual income or revenue of the country or national dividend. So what do you understand here? So the labor and capital. So in every country, there are people, the population of the country, people who are able to work. That was only called as the labor and capital, the money supply in a country. These two factors of production, the labor and capital, acts on the natural resources of a country. So every country is blessed with certain amount of natural resources. For example, if you take India, we have the Himalayas, which is a natural resource, the Gangetic Plains, the Nilgiri Mountains, all these are called as natural resources. The minerals, which are seen beneath our earth, okay? So all these are called as natural resources. It is not a man-made resource. So every country has got natural resources. So the labor and capital of a country, acting on its natural resources, produce annually every year, okay? So when you calculate national income, it is calculated for a particular year. So annually means for one particular year, it produces a certain net aggregate of commodities. What do you mean by commodities? Commodities are the goods. It can be raw material or it can be a finished item. So commodities can be material and immaterial. Material goods are tangible goods, goods that you can see, goods that you can touch, goods that have a shape. All these are called as material. You can use the material goods. What do you mean by immaterial goods? There are certain goods which you cannot see, but you can use those goods. Those goods are called as immaterial. For example, the service of a doctor, a service of an engineer, the service of a teacher, all these come under immaterial goods, or you can call it as services. Material goods can be seen, felt, whereas immaterial goods can be used, but you cannot touch it or you cannot see it. Okay, so goods are material and immaterial. So the labor and capital of a country, acting on its natural resources, produce annually a certain net aggregate of commodities, material and immaterial, including services of all kinds. So this is also called as true net annual income or revenue of the country or national dividend. This definition was given by Alfred Marshall. So what are the basic concepts of national income? The basic concepts of national income. So under this we have the GDP, or the gross domestic product, GNP, gross national product, NNP, net national product, NNP at factor cost, net national product at factor cost, personal income, disposable income, per capita income, real income, and GDP deflator. So these are some of the basic concepts of national income. So let us see gross domestic product. The first basic concept, gross domestic product or GDP. So what is GDP? GDP is the total market value of final goods and services produced within the country during a year. This is the most important term here, within the country. So every country produces goods and services. When I say final goods, it means the finished goods, okay? Not the intermediary goods. It means the final finished goods. GDP is the total market value. So every product brought to the market has got a price. That is only called as the market value. GDP is the total market value of final goods and services produced within the country during a year. So this is calculated at market prices. So the prices of a product sold in the market is only called as market price. You have two prices, factor cost and market price. I will explain that later to you. This is calculated at market prices and is known as GDP at market price. So what is the market price? Every good sold in the market has got a price. That is only called as market price. So GDP is calculated with respect to market price. So what is GDP? GDP is equal to C plus I plus G plus X minus M. Okay. So C is consumption goods. I is investment goods. This equation we have already seen in the first chapter. Four-sector economy. In a four-sector economy, you have the consumption, investment, government expenditure, X minus M. Similarly, here, what is the GDP? It is C plus I plus G plus X minus M. So what is C? C is consumption. So here it is consumption goods. It is not expenditure. It is consumption goods. I is investment goods. G is government purchases. X is export and M is import. X minus M can be positive or negative. If export is large, then it will be positive. If import is large, then it will be negative. So did you understand this? This is found on page number 22.4.1. You need to learn this definition thoroughly. You cannot write it in your own words. So the next one, net domestic product. What do you mean by net domestic product? First we saw gross domestic product. Now we are going to see net domestic product. What do you mean by net domestic product? Here look at this equation. NDP is equal to GDP minus depreciation. You know what is GDP? The value of all goods and services produced within a country. And this is measured in terms of market price. That is only called as GDP. What is GDP? It's the total market value of final goods and services produced within a country during a year. So NDP is GDP minus depreciation. So what is this new term, depreciation? It means wear and tear of the products, wear and tear of the equipments. As you start using the machines or anything, for example, if you start wearing your shoes, your footwear, initially it will be new. You will buy it for 100 rupees. Suppose you buy it for 100 rupees, the shoes will be a brand new shoes. After using it for a month, what happens? The shoe becomes old, okay? So in case you want to sell that shoe now to someone, you cannot sell it for 100 rupees. Nobody will buy it for 100 rupees from you because for rupees 100, they can get a brand new shoe in a shop. So in case you want to sell it to someone, it is called as a second-hand good. So when you sell it to someone, you have to reduce the value. Instead of selling for 100 rupees, you sell it for 80 rupees. So that 20 rupees which you have deducted from the initial price is only called as depreciation. In Tamil, they call it as Theimanam. As you start using a particular good, the value of the good depreciates. This is only called as depreciation. So what you have to do to calculate NDP, you have to subtract depreciation from GDP. Am I clear, girls? Are you able to understand? So NDP is the value of net output of the economy during the year. Some of the country's capital equipment wears out or becomes outdated each year during the production process. As you use the equipment, okay, some equipment becomes outdated, you will not be able to use it, or some equipments will undergo a lot of wearing and tearing. This is only called as depreciation. It's very simple. You wear, the more you wear, you tear. Okay? Dress poda poda enagum. Pudusa irukumbodhu nalla 100 rupees ku vaangumbodhu adu pudusa irukumbodhu nalla irukum. Adu wear panna panna adu tear aguna enna artham? Use panna panna adanudaiya value koranjite pogum. This is only called as depreciation. Next, gross national product. What we saw first was gross domestic product. Now we are going to see gross national product. Gross national product is the total measure of the flow of final goods and services at market value resulting from current production in a country during a year, including net income from abroad. This is the main term here. Till this, it is the same. It is the same as the GDP, the value of final goods and services produced within a country during a particular year. Till this point, it is the same. This is the GDP, including net income from abroad. So see the equation here. GNP is equal to GDP at market price plus net factor income from abroad. So here, some of the citizens of India might be working in other nations, Japan, Dubai, United States. And they will be earning there and sending their income here. This is only called as net factor income from abroad. So imagine after you finish your studies, your parents are here in India, whereas you are going to Germany to work there. So as you work there, they pay a salary for you in Germany. You receive that salary, you use some for your personal consumption, and you send the money to India, to your parents. So this income only is called as net factor income from abroad. So GNP is nothing but GDP plus net factor income from abroad. So what is GNP? GNP is equal to GDP at market price plus net factor income from abroad. In